Hello, my name is Olivia Steele, and I voice Lana for the monitor. I got involved in the project a couple months back. Dave sent me an email message thing on Facebook and asked me if I would be interested in playing one of the parts for the monitor. And I was like, yeah, I'm intrigued. This sounds interesting. And proceeded to tell me that there were darker themes involved in the project, and I was like, okay, I'm down with this, you know? Yeah, so that was it. He sent me a message on Facebook, and it all went from there. My favorite thing about Lana is, I would hate to just say her personality, but I guess facets of her personality, because there's a lot more to her than what you see. Because a lot of the time, she's only letting you see a portion of it. And then other times, like, some of it tends to slip through, like when she meets her uncle, obviously, because she doesn't like him very much. He kind of cracks her a bit. And, I like the way that she can slip in and out of different personalities, all while still being the same person. It's not like she's got personality disorder or anything, but she molds herself to different situations, and depending on the certain stimulus in the environment, she will change. And I guess that's like most any other people, but the way that I feel like Lana does it is just really intriguing and fascinating. I don't know that there is necessarily anything difficult to portray about Lana. Maybe more challenging. A lot of times with anything that has a darker theme, emotions play a huge part in accurately portraying any character. And if you fail those emotions and connecting with the character on that level, it'll be detrimental to the story and the overall execution of that story. So I would say that she was more challenging in those emotions, and probably more so than any other character present, because she has gone through so much. There is a lot of emotional fracturing with her character, and a lot that's hidden deep down inside. And I think getting her wrong in any way would just be bad. And thankfully, Dave thought that I did a really good job, and I really enjoyed doing it, especially towards the end with Act 3. I had an absolute blast. This may sound totally weird and wrong, but I honestly had fun diving into all of that torment and that just absolute agony that she's endured. And being able to portray that and stretch myself to be able to achieve that overall final performance was just really intriguing and super fascinating, and it was such a great experience. Do I share anything in common with Lana? To some degree, I do. It gets a little into, I guess, personal territory, but to some degree, I do. Not on quite the same level that she had certain past events happen to her, but I definitely have gone through probably, maybe I guess, a small percentage of what she herself has gone through, in terms of trusting people and being vulnerable and put in a position where others are able to take advantage of you. And that, I think, definitely helped with Lana, of trying to get into that mindset. And while I didn't have, you know, a whole world of experience to share with her, I at least did have the doorway cracked, and I could step into it a little bit and then try to explore from there. And yeah. I think in some way we have that, and in other ways how we tend to maybe deal with torment. I don't know that I'm quite as sarcastic with her. We slightly talk the same, I guess. We would also have that in common. That's probably about it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you will give The Monitor a thumbs up on Steam Greenlight, and be sure to check it out when the game comes out for your playing pleasures.